So we're going to tape this lady's foot, and taping functions for plantar fasciitis by reducing the tension in the arch, because the plantar fascia goes from the heel to the ball of the foot, and the tape is like an external splint that goes parallel to that, so it supports it indirectly. This is just another view of the fascia going from the heel to the ball of the foot, and again, the tape will be going parallel to that. So, what we're going to do is, we're going to tape her foot. The first piece is called the anchor strap. And that goes from right behind what some people might consider a bunion, or the first metatarsal head here. Out to the fifth metatarsal head. And then, this is called the anchor strap. That's step one. Step two are the cross straps. First piece goes just behind the weight-bearing ball of the foot here, just behind there. And then attaches to the anchor strap on each side. Then step three is the additional cross pieces, which overlap by about 50%. So I overlap by about half. I go up on the anchor strap, and then I come down across the foot to the outside. And again, I overlap again. Usually, three pieces might be all you need of these cross straps. Relax your foot. Then when you're done with that, it's okay if the heel is still exposed. In fact, usually we don't cover the whole heel up. Then the last piece is like that first piece. It's similar to an anchor strap. It covers up those loose ends. So it goes just above, and it follows that same pattern going around the heel, and it finishes it off fairly nicely. An optional piece would be to wrap around the whole rest of the foot. For most people, this is all you need. If you put this extra piece on, sometimes it feels too tight. But it does tie it all together nicely. So that's all done. The supplies that we used were 1-inch tape, 2-inch tape, a pair of scissors. This brand of tape is Johnson & Johnson Zonas, Z-O-N-A-S. And that's all there is to it. Some precautions, though, are that if you get the slightest skin irritation, or if you're allergic to tape or sensitive to tape, then take it off immediately. And if you're diabetic, you probably don't want to use it at all, or if you've got poor circulation, because if you get a skin blister, it can become infected. So, usually we just have people leave this on while they're going to be physically active. Like if it's a runner, you put it on while you're running, take it off immediately. The less time it's on your foot, the less likely you are to develop a sensitivity. And that's about it.